Good morning. I'm travelling on one of the oldest underground trains on the network. This is the Piccadilly Line with a 1973 stock, almost 50 years old now. Only the 1972 stock on the Bakerloo line on the tube is older. But there are new trains coming to the Piccadilly, and I'm off to get a train at King's Cross today to go and see a mock-up of the brand new Piccadilly Line train.
The current Piccadilly Line trains were built between 1974 and 1977, with the first one used in service on the Underground in 1975. 86 six-car trains were built in total, and they had a midlife refresh in the late 1990s, where the original transverse seating was removed and more luggage space for Heathrow passengers was introduced. But I'm off to Goole in Yorkshire today, where a new factory is currently being built, where Siemens will then build half of the new fleet of 94 trains here. And as it's an official press trip, I bumped in to a familiar face on the train. Everyone say hello to Tom from BBC London.
We've come to Doncaster. Normally I make videos when I say I'm out with the press office, I mean the TfL press office. Today is not a TfL press affair, today is a London Mayor's office press event because the Mayor's turning up.
All right, if we go in the front?
Yeah, absolutely.
So a quick drive up to Goole takes us to the site of what's officially known as the Goole Train Manufacturing Facility. It's just to the north of the Dutch River and the canal navigation that runs alongside. If you've watched my least used station Rawcliffe video, then you'll know that I've walked right past this spot before, and you can see clearly from the air just how large and impressive the site already is and is going to be.
So, we're in Goole, in East Yorkshire. We're on the site where Siemens have got their factory. So we're here to see a mock-up of the new tube train for London, as well as also see the state of the factory where the trains will be built. I've just realised that new tube for London, NTFL, is just TFL, Transport for London, with an N put on the front. What is that? That's fortuitous. NTFL. All right, quite early doors. I think we're going, no messing, we're going straight in. Is it in here?
Yes.
We're just going straight in? No messing?
No.
I thought there'd be like an induction or a briefing. No, no.
No, no, we're outside.
I can see it already. The new tube train for London is right there. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Welcome.
There's a bit there, and there's a bit there. All right, here we go, up the steps, through the door. Right, so, hey, I'm in London's new tube train. This is just a mock-up, I should say. So they put this reflective material in here that makes it look like it goes down. Is that, no, is that, there. That's really disconcerting. Okay, this is what the new maquette looks like. This will be on Piccadilly Line trains from 2024. Or 2025. Again, that's just mock-up, but I'm liking the maquette. Grab poles there. Okay, Tom Edwards from the BBC is here, just getting in the way of my video. You right, Tom?
Hello.
What do you reckon? I'll use you in my video.
Very nice.
Tom just said.
Very nice.
There we go.
Kind of Star Trek feel, I like it.
Star Trek feel.
Teleporters.
What's impressive is that this is the press photo that's been around for a while now of how the train may look, and the mock-up does exactly match the photo. Also, the new six-car trains are going to be air-conditioned and also have walk-through carriages as you currently do on subsurface S-stock units, and that is a complete first for deep-level tube rolling stock.
So this is very familiar to what you get on the Victoria line, where you've got the accessible area here with the fold-down seats. Is this wider? You'd have all the gubbins under here as normal. Note how there's a roundel just there. Priority seats. This seems deeper, the carriage line maps. I feel like normally the carriage line maps might be a little bit narrower, so that's deeper. And the advertising panels seem at a more severe angle. Okay.
And it was at this point in this mock-up carriage that I realised that there were two moquette designs, and that this is not the final one. Because this one is, yes, this is the final maquette that will be on the new Piccadilly Line trains, and we can now all start to play the game of guess the designs in the pattern. I'll start you off by pointing out that this is clearly Southgate Tube Station, which is a fantastic touch. Well done, TfL. If you can work out the others, leave them in the comments below.
How's the BBC report going, Tom?
Good. Fantastic. You keep getting in the way, though.
Show us your fancy
priority. Priority.
The internet want to see
news.
Tom Edwards' fancy 360 camera. How does it work?
I don't know.
The doors are wider too, we noticed, and the trains are also designed with sustainability in mind, reducing energy consumption by 20%. I'm still not sure, though, why these new trains have buttons on the doors, though, when you've not had to press a button on an underground train to open a door for many, many years. Right then, shall we take a peek at the mock-up cab as well?
Get to go into the cab. This is Will. It's very important at Siemens. He's gonna come in with me. Look, this bit is clearly a mock-up because it's
made out of wood.
It is wood. Okay, but we'll go inside. But how real is? I'm sat in the seat.
This is pretty real. Obviously, this is a demonstrator, so we will have some small changes between what you see in front of you. But you have the main driver's display, but it has a number of the fields you can go through.
So there's two displays. So the display on the left is?
The display on the left is showing, as we can see here, the cameras as if we were in a station.
And the right-hand display
and
is?
The right can go through event information, it can go through maintenance information, all sorts of diagnostics on the train.
Okay, the main control handle?
The main control is
there?
Yes.
Okay. There is a cab door here. You don't have to exit throughout the front.
No, this is emergency only.
That is emergency only. Okay, and standard. Oh, that.
Does it lift?
Okay, for PAs and etc.
Absolutely.
Okay, all right. Thank you very much.
No problem.
The design of the front of the train is completely futuristic. It's unlike any other tube train you've seen before. It's going to be incredible seeing one of these speed into a Piccadilly Line station and completely modernise the line. And these trains could be coming to other lines too, as I found out when I spoke to the Mayor of London, who at that point turned up and I asked him some questions.
Morning.
Good to see you.
Nice to see you. You won't remember this. Last time we met, we were doing Bus Hopper, so we were doing a bus event. Now we're doing a tube event.
Yeah.
I think next time we should do like a cycle event or something.
Or we can use the clipper or something.
We could do the clipper. But we're on the new Tube for London. I'm excited. Are you excited to see it?
It's fantastic. And the wonderful thing is, I mean, although this is just not the finished product, the Piccadilly Line, the trains we have there currently from the 1970s,
so
right?
What, 40, 45
it's
years
really,
old?
Yeah, almost as old as me. And the great thing about this, right, is they've got a design solution which increases the capacity of the trains by more than 10%. They're going to be air conditioned.
Yep.
You're going to be able to see all the way through. And it's what we deserve, what we need. But what's even better is the new trains are made in the UK. They're made here in Yorkshire. You know, the skills, the expertise, the engineering, the equipment is fantastic. And so we're helping the economy here, but they're building trains that are the world's finest. It's a win-win-win.
You mentioned economy, so my one tricky question for you is, everyone knows there's a little bit of issue with TfL funding right now. Might that have an effect with the build of these or future build of these? Because they're also going to come, I believe, to the Central and Bakerloo line as well.
So here's the deal. When I signed the order with Siemens, Siemens said because we've guaranteed them the order for 94 new trains, rather than these trains being built in Vienna, they would invest in a new factory here in Goole. So Siemens, to give them credit, are building a new factory which is state of the art. That's created 250 jobs. Once this factory opens, there'll be another 700 jobs. I've met some of the apprentices who'll be benefiting, but also the supply chain are jobs and business as well. Now, what Siemens are saying quite reasonably is, if you order more trains, we can invest more,
right?
So and actually the trains here on the Piccadilly Line are exactly the same, basically, as the trains we'd need in other deep tube lines. So Bakerloo, Central, Waterloo and Cissy. We'd save money because it's not a new spec. Siemens would be able to use this factory. More jobs could be created. It's a virtuous circle. The problem is, the fly in the ointment is, because of the pandemic, we've had fewer people using public transport.
I hear that's been
we've
a problem.
We've had less money. so we need the government to give us the long-term capital deal, which means good news for London, better trains, not 1970s trains, but also good news for the people here in East Yorkshire. Honestly, we need to be ordering more things that are made in the UK. It's not being nationalistic, it's just common sense. But actually, we need that long-term deal. And I think, you know, if the government gives us the long-term deal, we could be ordering more trains, more kit, it's more jobs, more growth. It really is a good news story.
Love it. Thank you. That's it. Easy.
No, cheers.
Unless you want to tell me when Crosswell's opening. That's a joke. No,
I could, but I'd have to kill him then.
Well, you can't blame me for asking, but he wasn't letting on. Oh, well.
And so there we have it, in a nondescript shelter on a site which is still being built here in Goole, in the East Riding of Yorkshire. Piccadilly Line trains replacing the 73 stock, the new Tube for London. Also, should hopefully be coming to the Central and Bakerloo lines in the following years. It's exciting to see them. Brand new maquette as well. Any day that there's a brand new maquette is a good day. Thanks very much. Press subscribe. See you soon.